Good morning, students. In previous class, we discussed about train. Where does it come from? Now also, today we are going to learn or continue the same topic. Today we are going to learn in this lesson condensation. What is condensation? What is condensation? The process of condensation of water vapor into water is called condensation. The process of conversion of water vapor into water is called as condensation. The process of conversion of water vapor into water is called as condensation. Now we are going to learn the topic. In winter, the air is cool, very cool in our surroundings. When you wake up in the early morning, if you stand in front of the mirror and if you take in breath and if you once give out breath. Take in and give out. At that time, like this, at that time you can observe on the mirror the water droplets. Otherwise, if you speak with others, otherwise if you yawn, like this, at that time the cloud, the small cloud observe in front of your mouth. What is that one? Where does it come from? The respiration takes place in your body. If you breathe in air, if you breathe out air, at that time if you yawn, with that the water vapor present in the body, from the lungs, it comes from the lungs to the outside of the environment. So then here inside the body is warm. If you compare with the outside environment in winter season, it is very cool. Then the water vapor from our body, when it comes outside from the mouth or nose, at that time the water vapor suddenly cooled or converted into water. From water vapor to water, water droplets, then it forms as a cloud in front of our mouth. You can observe the water droplets on the mirror. Understood? What is this one? It is nothing but just like a small cloud in front of our mouth. This is one example of condensation. One more is nothing but you can observe the water droplets on the grass in winter mornings. Water droplets. So where does this water droplets come from? Where does means from the stomata, the water, excess water come outside from the plants. At that time the water vapor when comes, at that time the outside environment is very cool. Then the water vapor convert into the water. So the water droplets settle on the grass, leaves of the grass, upper surface leaves of the grass. Understood? So next, let us continue the condensation, some other topics. So first here, take some water in a glass and add some pieces of ice to it. Observe for few minutes. After few minutes, what you observe? You can observe the droplets on the surface of the glass. What is this? You can see one more thing. If you take one water bottle from the fridge and if you keep outside on the table, then what you observe? You can observe some water droplets on the water bottle. From where this water droplets come from? From where means the environment or the air contains water vapor. But here the water vapor present in the atmosphere or air is warmer than the bottle surface area. So the water vapor present in the air touches the water bottle and suddenly cools down and condensed. What is that one? I told you the process of conversion of water vapor into water is called as condensation. So the conversion here, the water vapor present in the air converted into the water on the bottle surface, or just like it, which is given in the textbook. If you take one glass of water, if you add some ice cubes, then the surface area of the glass became cool, very cool than the outside environment. Then what happens here? The water vapor present in the air, when touches the outer surface of the glass, it suddenly cooled down, condensed. Water vapor converted into water. This is the reason. Understood? Next, what changes do you observe the outer surface of the glass? You observe some water droplets on the outer surface of the glass. You would observe formation of small drops of water on the outer surface of the glass. Why are these drops formed? Why are formed these drops? Outer surface is the glass, outer surface is cooler than the outside environment. Then the water vapor, when touches the glass surface, that condensed and settled as water droplets on the glass. Do they get formed if there is no ice in the glass? If there is no ice in the glass, they do not form. Ice cold water in the glass cools its surface. Air around the glass contains water vapor, which is warmer than the surface of the glass. Due to the cold glass, air close to its surface will also become cooler. This changes the water vapor in the air around the surface of the glass into water and forms small drops on the outer surface of the glass. I think you had understood clearly. Next, have you ever observed in your daily life where water vapor changes into water? List out them. Where water vapor changes into water? Did you observe at your home? I will say one more example. Your mother cooks food. Your mother prepares rice. So the raw rice, she clean the raw rice and she pours some water and she keeps on the stove. After some time, the rice are cooked and the total water present in the water in the rice, some may evaporate, and after some time she keeps a lid. After few minutes, if you switch off the stove, after few minutes, if you open the lid, you can observe the water droplets on the lid of the rice bowl. Where does this water come from? Means here the water vapor from the water of the rice converted into water. Here the outer surface of the plate is cooler than the inner surface of the rice bowl. So that's why the water vapor in that is cooled down, condensed as water. Water vapor is converted into water here. Okay, this is also one more example. Next, the process of conversion of water vapor into water is called as condensation. Next topic is clouds and rain. Next topic is clouds and rain. On a warm day, the sun heats up the ground, seas, oceans, rivers, ponds, lakes. Okay, this water, when heats up, that can convert into water vapor by the process of evaporation. Here, what is going on? On a warm day, the water bodies contain water. That water heats up and convert into water vapor. At that time, the water vapor, water converted into water vapor. This water vapor rises up into the atmosphere. As we move away from the surface of the earth, the air becomes cooler. Hence, when water vapor reaches higher levels, it condenses due to contact with cool air and forms small drops or water droplets. These tiny droplets remain floating in the air at higher levels of the atmosphere and appear as clouds. Here you have to know one thing. On a hot summer day, the water present in the water bodies, just like oceans, seas, rivers, ponds, lakes, the water converted into water vapor. This is called as what? Evaporation.
Water on a stove. This is called as what? Evaporation.
properties do you observe between the, if you pour some cool water on a plate and if you heat water on the bowl on a stove, if you observe what happens, the water which you keep on the stove evaporates, the water convert into water vapor in it. But here if you pour cool water on a plate, that can convert into water vapor, yes, but it takes time, it takes much more time, 2-3 hours time to evaporate the water. But if you keep on the stove, that convert into water easily. Next topic is rain. The clouds formed on the surface of the different water bodies do not stay there. When the clouds formed on the different bodies, water bodies, they do not stay in one place. They move. They start to move from one place to another in the direction of winds. In the direction of the winds, the water vapor converted into water at the time of rain. But when the atmosphere is hot, the clouds formed at that time, so they do not stay in that place only. They move from one place to another place through wind. They move in the direction of winds. As more clouds come together, they become laden with water vapor. Winds bring the clouds from the sea to the land. Winds bring the clouds from the sea to the land. The colder air in the upper layers of the atmosphere cools the clouds. Now the clouds are formed in the upper layers of the atmosphere. When the cool breeze touches the clouds, that convert into water droplets, and it begin to rain. Have you observed the color of a cloud before rain? It is gray in color, dark gray in color. How are clouds converted into rain? When the cool breeze touches the clouds, when the clouds gather together, became laden at that time, when cool breeze touches the clouds, at that time the clouds convert into water droplets and it begin to rain. We all know that without clouds it will not be possible to get rains. And that all clouds do not cause rain. Do all clouds cause rain? No. Some changes take place in the clouds before they cause rain. What changes do you notice in the sky, in the atmosphere before it rains? The atmosphere becomes cool and we observe cool wind and it becomes cool and dark, and suddenly the rain starts. Okay? Wow. Next, what changes takes place clouds before raining? Clouds become laden and a cool breeze touches the clouds. They become dark gray in color. They gather together with cool breeze. When cool breeze touches the clouds, it again starts the rain. The clouds moving in the air are generally at higher levels. Sometimes the cool breeze coming along with the air makes the clouds cooler. This leads to water droplets present in the clouds to condense and form large water droplets. When the cool breeze touches the clouds at that time, the water vapor present in the clouds convert into water or condense as water, and they start rain. The size of the water drops and clouds become heavy and descend towards the earth. The color of such clouds changes from white to gray, giving us the feeling of dark clouds gathering. When the size of the water drops increase further, it becomes difficult for the cloud to hold them and water drops begin to fall. This is called rain. In our daily life, we observe that before raining, clouds descend towards the earth's surface and experience a cool breeze before rainfall. In very cold conditions, the drops of water turn into crystals of ice and fall as snow. Sometimes big drops of water solidify into ice and fall as pieces of ice known as hailstones. Dear students, once read the topic condensation and clouds and rain topic also once read and prepare for the exam. Complete the fair notes, prepare for the exam.